My dear students, I am Professor Manohar from MIT University, MIT Business School, Chennai. Dear my students, today we have to talk about basics of economics. See, unless we know the concept of basics of economics, we cannot understand the other concepts in macro level. Macro level means by and large we can look at the price factors, unemployment or employment generation, and factors of production and other aspects like national income, then gross domestic product, GDP, we call it as GDP, gross domestic product, then and other aspects. Say for example, taxation, tax system, taxation. So these are the aspects we look at in a macro level. Unless we cannot understand the microeconomics, micro level, that is microeconomics means in micro level, that is basic level, then only we can go through the other macro level aspects of gross domestic product, taxation, national income, employment generation. So these are the aspects of the nationwide aspects in economics. You understand? So what is economics now? What is economics? Any of you, can you tell about economics? What is economics? Don't worry. See, economics is nothing but the human activities of every individual. Each and every individual, they are doing some activity. Activity means in their day-to-day life, they go to the market, buy some product, they go to the market, they try to desire to purchase something that some extent they reject it. They want to buy it, but they don't have enough of money in his pocket. So immediately he rejected or postponed it. He postponed to purchase the particular product. You understand? See, for example, today I am going to market to purchase one particular vegetables. See, for example, onion. You know the price of onion today. See, today the price of onion price per kilogram, that is 160 rupees. But what I think about the lesser price I have to purchase in the market, I have money of only 100 rupees, I have. But I go to the market, then only I know the price of 1 kilo of onion, 160 rupees. So 60 rupees shortage, 60 rupees of money shortage in my pocket. But I want to purchase 1 kilo of onion. So immediately what shall I do? I try to postpone my purchase. Instead of purchase 1 kilo of onion for 160 rupees, because of shortage of money in my pocket, I postpone to purchase half cage or 250 cage. That is 250 cage means kilograms, half cage or quarter cage, kal kilo, ara kilo. So that way I try to purchase because the shortage of money in my pocket, isn't it? Or I have to alternate to change my purchase. I need not to purchase the onion or the big size onion, ballari. We call it as, colloquially we call it as ballari. Ballari is a big size onion. That product price may be very lesser. See, for example, 50 rupees per kilo. 50 rupees per kilo. So instead of purchase the sambar onion, I try to purchase the ballari onion. So that way the human activity is plenty here. Plenty of human activities. So we call it as human wants are unlimited. Human wants are unlimited. Human wants are unlimited. How do you say unlimited? Suppose an individual, I fulfill my needs, immediately the next need arises. So for example, I go to the hotel to take my breakfast. In the morning, go to the hotel, I ordered 2 idlis. So once I consume the 2 idlis, that immediately my need to go for another one, that is one dosa. After I consume 2 idlis, immediately my wants go to order the next one, dosa. Immediately I order to dosa. Then I need the other chutney, variety of sambars here. So my need, by that way, my need and requirement or necessities going up. We can classify the human wants or necessities in different ways. So what do we call it as? The classification of human wants. See, these are the things we got to look into in basics of economics. Unless we understand, again, the previously I told you, see, unless we understand the basic concepts of the individual activity, unless it's very difficult to understand this way, we cannot understand the big level of the national income or the national economy. We call it as national economy. Isn't it? Understand? See, now you look at the board here. These are the basic economic concepts. Dear my students, in the first introduction part of the basics of economics, now I hope to understand you have a little knowledge about the basic idea about the human activity, how the human beings, they go to the market, in what way they are doing their economic activities in their day-to-day life. Now, we look at the slides here, stage by stage. See, now, what is economics in general? What do you think about? See, what I said a little earlier, where we are living in this environment, lot of resources around us, resources like natural resources or man-made resources or other resources what we are using day by day regularly. Some extent the resources may be plenty, some extent the resources may be very, very less. We call it as scarcity. We call it as scarcity. Scarcity means very, very limited. The source is very limited. Where the sources either plenty or scarce, how the human behavior, how this individuals they behave, make use of the resources, either it is plenty or very, very limited. We call it as scarce economy. We call it as scarce economy or scarcity. See, little more we can think about the basic idea of the economics. There are some theories says about either the classical economist, either Adam Smith or Alfred Marshall. So they are the classical economist. They are the very founder of the economic concept. See, for example, Adam Smith is the father of economics. Adam Smith is the father of economics. In 1776, he propounded the theory of wealth of nation. See, little earlier we look at that the resources available around us or in the environment where we are living. So, the resources, what he says here, according to Adam Smith, the national economy, the economy of the country based on the whatever the resources available, the resources he may say as a wealth, we call it as wealth, wealth of nation, wealth of nation, wealth of nation. A country in what way they flourish more and more resources, that way the economy of the country become very rich. We call it as the rich country. See, for example, the rich country, what do you say? Either America or Russia or some other countries, that there are list of countries that very rich country. But whereas in India, still now we are calling is a poor country or a developing country. Why we are using the particular word? Because we are not supposed to use the resources available in the environment. In what way we are make use of the resources available with us, that way the productivity increases, that way the manpower properly utilizing, that way the market stability increased. So, these are the factors influencing to determine the national economy. See, here, look at here, the scarcity is the condition in which our wants, either our wants, either it is fulfilled or not yet fulfilled. So, the next one, since we are unable to have everything we desire, we must make choices. Choice is very, very important. How the choices? Choice. Choices. Choices means what? See, every before us, lot of resources, lot of material, lot of demands, lot of wants, likes, dislikes, lot of things that. Out of which, how an individual behave to select the right one or which he needs very most or very best. That is choices. Choice among the resources. See, little earlier we look at the example how the customers, they are go to the market, how they are selecting among the various varieties of vegetables, fruits or eatable items, how they are identify and select one from the choices. Now we go to the next slide. Now you can easily understand, economics defined. Economics is a social science concerned with efficient use of limited resources to achieve maximum satisfaction, maximum level of satisfaction. That is very, very important. Unless I satisfy at optimum level or maximum level, we cannot fulfill the economic needs of the individual. That's why we call it as the limited resources. Within the limited resources, how the individual behave to make use of the limited resources and he satisfy himself at maximum level. Now you understand. So the study of how individuals and societies deal with limited resources, that is called scarcity. Now, dear my students, during my introduction part, I mentioned micro and macro. What is micro and macro? Micro means is a small one, very little. Macro level means macro. Macro means very big one, large size. See, similarly, the study of economics in two ways, either it is micro level or in macro level. Micro level means the individual of human being or individual product or individual factory. So that way, individually, small way, we look at the factors influencing or what are the activities it is going on in a small level, that is we call it as micro level, that is a study of a small activity or small item or small transaction or small functions, we call it as is a microeconomics. Look at here, a study of small economic units such as individual firms or individual industry or market or either it is a labor force or other personal decision making, personal desires, wants, likes, dislikes. So these are the things we got to study in microeconomics. Then next, macroeconomics. What is macroeconomics? Macroeconomics, already I told you in a big way. See, study of the large economic as a whole or in its basic subdivisions. See, for example, the individual income of the individual is a study of microeconomics. Similarly, in macroeconomics, the income of the whole country, the income of the whole region, the income of the people, those who are living in a particular state, the whole unit is a macroeconomics. National economic growth, government, how much the money is spending on the activities or welfare activities of the public. There is a government spending, there is government expenditure. Then inflation. Inflation is nothing but it's a price hike continuously. Price hike continuously, it goes up, the money value also reducing little bit. The people, they are very struggling to purchase or to fulfill their needs. There is an inflation. We look at in a later part, in a last unit, in third and fourth unit, we can look at the inflation. Then unemployment, similarly unemployment. So, how the unemployment, this is a very big issue also, that how the government spending money to reduce the unemployment problem. So, these are the things in a macro level, this is a very big concept that. So, macro level. So, these are the two difference of the micro and macro economics. Now, we could say economics. How the economics, frequently we talk about economics or economy. Frequently we are talk about. Wherever you go to the scenario, any national conference or international conference, the people, they are using the words economics or country's economy, it's coming down, or export, import. So these are the words some technically they are using frequently. So how the economics, so that is a very important to look at how the economics is being used in our day to day life. So how economics is used, this is a very big question. That see, economists like Adam Smith or Marshall or Samuelson, so they are lot of economists, that they are classical economists and neo classical or modern economists also come up day by day. They are giving new theories, new concept. They are the modern economist. So the economist use the scientific method to make generalization and abstractions to develop theories, some modern theories, new concepts. This is called theoretical economics. We call it as theoretical economics. Theoretically, they say some concept, some principles. These theories are then applied. So whatever the theory says here, we have to try to apply the theory which is applicable in our day to day life or not. This is very important. So the theories are then applied to fix the problems or meet economic goals. This is called a policy economy. We call it as economic policy. There are one is theory, another one is policy. So basics of economics and economic policy, how the economics is worked out in economic policy. Policy means decision making. How the theories is applicable to implement the policy, policy of the government for the welfare of the public. That is economic policy. There are two aspects, that one is the theoretical economics, another one is policy economics. We call it as either positive and normative. Positive economics or normative economics. Positive economics means a positive statement based on the availability of the facts, or avoids the value judgment. What is, we cannot say in generalize this is happened, this will happen. We cannot say there are some facts that yes, either the product is available in the market, yes it's available. Is the price of the product, yes it's the price of the product. The facts which is available, we cannot say orally or unfactual things. Poyyana oru thagavala solla mudiyadhu. This is a positive statement. Then next one is normative statement. Normative statement means it includes value judgment. Either it is possible to what the facts it says earlier. That is judgment. That is normative things. Now we look at the next one. See, think at the margin. We call it as frequently using the marginal level. Marginal. See, for example, the individual's preference is marginal. What is marginal? Margin means what? Margin means is nothing but is obtainable or factual. That is a margin. That is a possibilities. Easy to understand, we can use possibilities. See, for example, see a small example is given here in this table. The time of watching movies, how much the benefit we are gaining or satisfying through which we are spending money to see the movie, the particular movie. How many times we are using to look at the particular movie? How much of satisfaction we are gaining? So these are the things about the margin. See, for example, a individual, he is very first time he is spending his money. He is a dollar rate here. We take it as a 100 rupees or 200 rupees. First time I spend 200 rupees spending to look at the particular movie. Second time and third time, so automatically my intention to reduce my, because that much of cost I am spending more and more. How many times I spend the cost, right? So based on the individual's affordability, we call it as affordability. We call it as affordability. Affordability of the individual. Offering. Affordability means what? Offer. Offering. Offering. How much money, how much of money I am ready to spend for the particular product or any service I want to consume or utilize. This is marginal analysis. We call it as the marginal analysis. In the previous slide, just only the margin. What is marginal? Now the analysis part, marginal analysis. See, in economics, there are some specific terminology we are using that. What is margin? Margin means nothing but, it's an addition. Margin means, it's an additional. See, every additional unit of money I am spending more, the level of satisfaction, the level of benefits, the level of gain, either may be increasing or some extent reducing also that. That we call it as the marginal analysis. Now, look at the marginal analysis. How the economic theory, it works in marginal analysis part. See, thinking on the margin or marginal analysis, it involves making decisions based on the additional units or additional benefits or the additional cost. Additional cost. Every additional cost incurred stage by first time, second time, third time, the benefits either may be reducing stage by stage. For example, you have been shopping at the mall for half an hour. See, you are spending half an hour in a shopping mall. Suppose if you spend more time, another half an hour, another half an hour, another 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, the same kind of benefit or the your benefit may be reducing some extent. The additional, that we call it as here, the additional benefit of shopping for an additional half an hour or 1 hour, it might outweigh the additional cost. That is, we call it as opportunity cost. We call it as opportunity cost. You have to spend more money additionally. Every hour where you are spending more hours in a shopping mall or a cinema theater or in recreating shops that, or entertainment showrooms that, how much time you are spending more and more, that way your cost also increasing. Additional cost, additional cost. That way you are spending more money, that way you are getting benefits. After 3 hours, the additional benefit from staying an additional half an hour would likely be less than the additional cost. Not that much of benefit you got it that earlier, because first half an hour you spend 100 rupees. See, another half an hour additional 50 rupees you spend that, but the level of satisfaction or benefits is very less one, little more. That is marginal analysis, we call it as marginal analysis, says that. Next slide. Now we look at the key economic assumptions. That what are the key assumptions, key economic assumptions? There are 5 economic assumptions. That one is society's wants are unlimited. See, already in the introduction part itself I told you human wants are unlimited. Human wants are unlimited. Once I satisfy my wants, immediately the next likes or wants immediately arise. Once I complete all the needs, that there is no limitation at all, there is no stop at all. Again the next wants, next level of likings immediately arise. That so that the human wants are unlimited, but all resources are scarce, all sources are scarce. Already I told you the scarce resources available with us. The economy says how the individuals, they are ready to utilize, make use of the resources available, the limited resources, how effectively they make use to satisfy themselves. That is economics. The first point, the first assumption says that the human wants are unlimited, but at the same time all the resources are limited, limited scores. That is scarcity. The second principles or second assumption, due to scarcity, see one side scarce resources, out of which how the human behavior. So automatically next one, choices. He has to select the which one is very most needed or very much needed. That is, choices must be made. Every choices has a cost. Every choices made a cost. It's not a free. Whatever you want to purchase, that you have to bear the cost. Cost basis. Due to scarcity, choices must be made. Every choice has a cost. Then third principle or third assumption, everyone's goal is to make choices that maximize their satisfaction. So everybody we want to something, that to satisfy ourselves, but the satisfaction level, maximum level, maximize our level of satisfaction. So everyone acts in their own self interest. See, my interest may be differ from this one, next one, or other people. That my choice is to purchase this particular pen, but the next one, my friend choice is to purchase the other pen. Similarly, the every individual choices is differ from person to person, place to place. Then fourth one, everyone acts rationally by comparing the marginal cost or marginal benefits. Every marginal, what we earlier we studied, that marginal, marginal means what? Additional. Every additional money or every additional hours to spend in a place, that it may be the cost, some extent of the cost when we incurred the every extent of hours or every additional hours we spend that. So this is the fourth principles, comparing the marginal cost and marginal benefits of every choices. Every selection of choices that it deals or it depends on the individual choices, the choices based on the every additional cost and benefit, cost and benefit. We look at in the later part, later chapter, cost benefit analysis. What is cost benefit analysis? Cost benefit analysis we look at later. Then last assumption, real life situations can be explained and analyzed through simplified models and graphs. See, real life situations, earlier we look at some slides here. See, the facts, economics is a study about the facts of the activity, the facts of informations available in the market or in environment. The facts which is may be analyzed, applied, analyzed and applied. So the real life situations can be explained and analyzed through simplified models and graphs. So the purpose of the economic says, what it says, whatever the theory says, that the theories which is applied or applicable to understand or to know the real facts of the activity in the nationwide. Okay, so up to this level we stop it. That can you recollect whatever we studied little earlier? Can I ask a few questions that you try to tell the answer? Now, any one of you, can you tell what is economics? What is economics? Yes, exactly. Your answer is right. Economics is nothing but is a study of human behavior or the activity of the human beings or individual, either individually or the whole group. Right? Very good. What is scarcity? Any of you, can you say scarce means what? What is scarce? Yes, exactly. Scarce means is nothing but limited or some shortage. We call it a simple. Yes, exactly. Shortage, very limited. Plenty of money I have, shortage of money I have. Very little money, he has lot of money. Okay, so scarce means limited resources, right? So what else we have seen? That microeconomics. Yes, very good. Microeconomics. Similarly, macroeconomics. What is microeconomics? Yes, microeconomics is nothing but a study of individual man, individual factory, individual industry, individual market, individual product. So this is micro level. This is a microeconomics. Whereas what is macroeconomics? Yes, exactly. Macroeconomics is nothing but is a study of the whole thing. Right. Very good, my dear students. We look at the other aspects of the economic concepts that in next class. That when you come to tomorrow, you collect more information about what are the basic economic activities is going on in our country. That you go to the library, look at newspaper or economic journals, you collect some informations. See, for example, in newspaper, in last pages, that is market, international trade, that is one articles may be that. You collect some information. Then price of vegetable, price of gold and silver, petrol price, what are the products available in the market that. So these are the general informations that all economic activities. Okay, you collect the informations, you submit as a assignment in next class. Thank you so much.